big comic book collection. I wish I still had it, because it would be worth so much money right now. It was Golden Age, Silver Age, Marvel, DC comics. They had the early Batman, the early Superman, the Spider-Man, X-Men, Fantastic Four, you name it. These are a couple I still have, and you'll notice that there's a connection here to what I write. There's Circe and the Sorceress turning Superman into a beast. And over here, of course, that's Odin holding the body of the god Thor. So already I was getting into mythology, I just didn't know it. Now that would have been cool if I could have just read that. Unfortunately, I had to read other stuff, and things really got bad when I got into middle school. The only thing he liked in elementary school was Greek mythology. He thought that was pretty cool. That's him dressed up as Hades, the Lord of the Dead. And so, to keep him interested in school, I started telling him bedtime stories about Greek mythology. Because Haley was dyslexic and ADHD, still is, I decided to create a character who was ADHD and dyslexic, like him. And I said, you know what? If you have those conditions in you, there's a pretty good chance you're a demigod. And he was like, yeah. And that was how was born Stories of Peter Johnson. Or of Percy Jackson, whatever. Haley told me I should write the story down. I didn't think anybody would like it. But I sent it off to New York. Right away, we got a call from an agent, Nancy Gault. She said, this is great. I want to represent you. She sent it to Disney Hyperion Publishers. My first editor there, Jennifer Besser, said, oh, we love this, we want to publish the whole series. Some of you holding that, please don't, you're gonna hurt yourself because they're really heavy and the things weigh like 10 pounds. Be careful with that. So that's what I'm working on. Here's some of the art from the Greek gods. A lot of John Rocco's illustrations. My favorite one is probably the one with Zeus. Somebody on Twitter zoomed in and said, why is Zeus holding French fries? And can I have none? Zeus is like, no, they're my fries. Magnus Chase, you're thinking, that name sounds familiar. Chase, Annabeth Chase. That's not a coincidence, they are related. Now, how exactly? There's a little hint in Blood of Lovers. You find that on your own. They do exist in the worlds of Magnus and the worlds of Percy Jackson. They're side by side. Will they interact at any point? I can't tell you. But I can tell you that Magnus and his series are set right here in Boston. The first book of the series is called Sword of Summer, and it will be out this time next year, so I hope you guys enjoy it.